What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the Forever Stranded Minecraft modpack. Playing through challenges in Minecraft servers are common activities across the community, but after a while, you might want something a little bit different. You could start to look for mod packs, but they are all different in some ways, including if there's a story to follow or not. If you're looking for a story-driven mod pack, then let me introduce you to Forever Stranded, which forces players to survive on an alien planet after crashing their ship. There is hardly any water, food, or supplies, making this a difficult challenge to overcome, but a great way to test your skills. Anyone wanting to play Forever Stranded will need to install the CurseForge launcher used for downloading mini mod packs. Head to the download page and press download on your operating system, and then save and open this file on your computer to start the installation. Once it's finished, start up the launcher and click Browse Mod Packs from the menu, and then enter Forever Stranded in the search field and press install. Wait for this to download and click play from My Mod Pack. We strongly recommend using a new server profile for the server installation, since Forever Stranded comes with an existing world needed for its gameplay. Head towards your Apex server panel and find the Game File section, and then click the Currently Selected option, revealing a drop-down menu. In this area, type Forever Stranded in the text box and press it, and then you can click Change Version and Use Included World in the following prompts. Afterwards, press Restart Now to start loading the mod pack on your server, and when everything is done, join with your installed profile from CurseForge. When you first join your modded server, you'll immediately notice how different it is compared to a normal map. You will be surrounded by sand with only a crash site nearby. Keep in mind that your character can overheat and become tired, especially if you don't eat or drink any water. Additionally, players should have a few items in their inventory upon freshly joining the world. One of these starter items is called Better Questing, and it allows you to view available missions to complete. The first chapter is called Basic Survival, containing necessary steps to start obtaining essential resources. Clicking on highlighted quests will give you a brief description of required task items and rewards. While inside of the crashed ship, there's a room with a single chest. This holds bone meal, water bottles, and a sapling to get you started. Make sure to grab everything stored in this container, but don't waste it right away. These will not respawn or appear again in the ship. After obtaining them, you can complete the first quest to receive rewards. This will include a piece of dirt that'll help you grow trees. Place the piece of dirt down somewhere and then use the sapling on it. Afterwards, make it grow faster with your bone meal to instantly get a tree, and then break the wood logs and the leaves, which hopefully will drop you apples to get an early source of food. Do this until you're satisfied, but make sure you have enough wood planks since they'll come in handy for more quests in the first chapter. As you make more progress in the basic survival chapter, specific stations are going to be required. These include stencil tables, part builders, and others to help you craft strong tools. Everyone can freely make default equipment in the crafting table, but it won't be as powerful as using the modded items. The Forever Stranded mod pack is a challenging experience for any Minecraft player, but here are a few tips and tricks that'll help you stay alive in the harsh environment. An extremely popular mob farming concept with this mod pack is to build underneath the crashed ship. This allows you to attract hostile mobs while keeping you safe. The main block required for this is a slab, as it'll protect you from damage. However, crafting a pickaxe and sword is also needed for this task. Most players should have these by now, but make sure you have enough of them just in case they break. Like I said before, your character can overheat and become exhausted. This will eventually kill you if nothing is done about it, so make sure to jump into liquid. Players can find a stream of water outside of the ship, but there's also dripping lava inside that can achieve the same goal. If you're unsure when overheating is happening, then make note of the ball icon near your hotbar. This will be gray when a player isn't too hot, but it slowly turns orange as your character overheats. If left unchecked, it'll turn into a fire icon that shakes and will damage your character. Besides managing your heat and fighting off mobs, you'll also need to take care of your hunger and thirst. One of the first food items players will stumble upon are apples, since they come from trees when breaking leaves. Unfortunately, this isn't enough to sustain your hunger. Luckily, once you've completed some quests, zombie jerky will become available. As for water, players need to finish the Need Water activity for required materials to obtain liquid. There are other methods too, such as crafting dirty water bottles with dirt and normal bottles. While exploring the sandy world, you'll come across unique structures. Some of these mimic vanilla ones, like the desert temples or the mineshafts, but the vast majority of them will be custom types from the modpack. Almost all of these will have lootable chests containing valuable or bad items for players to use. There is one special area in the world that contains an entire city. This is mostly found by following the quest line, but you can come across it accidentally too. Other structures to explore are large towers filled with several levels of mobs and loot. After defeating them all, there's a golem boss at the very top. This is an extremely powerful and dangerous fight, so make sure you have basic armor, supplies, and weapons to win. After doing this, you'll be rewarded with a lot of valuable items. These can include enchanted golden apples, diamonds, emeralds, and more. Further along in your journey, there will be complicated factories, large farms, and tons of other useful aspects. For example, lifeblood crystal items can be found or awarded to players that give them more hearts. Quest chapters like Moving Worlds or Creating Life is when the Forever Stranded mod pack truly becomes detailed. Playing through challenges and overcoming obstacles will lead you on brand new missions, allowing you to have different sceneries and gather unique resources. Before we get into the common issues, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. If you're unable to join the server, make sure you load in the mod pack through CurseForge and you're running the matching version. Our servers use the latest version of the pack, so make sure your CurseForge instance is running the same one. If the mod pack isn't loading, on the panel, make sure you're selecting Forever Stranded from the game file section. The files in this mod pack can conflict with other files, so if you haven't already, we do recommend creating a new server profile for the pack. Otherwise, it could be a memory issue, so make sure to have enough allocated memory on the CurseForge launcher before you play. Some people like mod packs where there is no story, and some people need a story to keep them on the right track. If you're looking for a brand new way to play the game with an intense story to follow, then the Forever Stranded mod pack is made just for you.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.